Ladies and gents, welcome to the long-awaited first Settle In YouTube video. I have been saying for some time that I would eventually get around to doing a YouTube series, and I finally got the time to do it. So we are going to kick this channel off with the Burton Albion Road to Glory save. A team close to my heart, it's the team I follow, it's the team I support. I know there's not many of us out there. It's a bit crazy. But that is who we're going to do, boys. So please join me in this journey as we try and take Burton Albion right to the top, to the very top. The very small budget that we do have. Lads, let's jump into it. Right, we are literally as early as we can be. I have done nothing apart from pick the tournament that we're going to enter for pre-season. I don't know how much gameplay we'll actually get in to this episode. But I'm going to start with looking at the squad. Let's have a look at what we've got here. So O'Hara is on loan. He's on loan from United, like IRL for last season. I probably don't need three keepers, so I'll probably get rid of Hawkins. In fact, let's just do that now. Let's just get rid of some Deadwood early doors. Again, three left backs with Daniels, Hutchinson and Wallace. Do we need three? Probably not. His contract's expiring in 12 months. He's 31. The other two are fairly young. So Daniel, I'm afraid you're gone, fella. That'll go down popular Burton fans because he's not the most popular lad at the club, I can tell you that. Centre-backs, again, we have got quite a few. John Joe Tool, East End, there's no matter what. Knight's on loan from Chelsea. It says contract's expiring in 12 months, but he's actually on loan IRL. Buxton, obviously now the player manager, I mean, he's got to stay. Yevon Anderson, 52 rated. I'm going to be quite cutthroat here, lads. I'm not even going to really think too much about it. He's on loan from Leeds, so that's absolutely fine. Right backs, again, that's probably where we're going to look to try and get a loan signing in because we are very light at right back. And if Brayford gets injured, that doesn't look good. CDMs, Fox, IRL was injured for the whole of this season. But we've got Quinn there, so I'm happy with that. Got Powell on the left, signed this season from West Ham, I believe. And we've got Edwards, Fraser's obviously no longer with the club. He's one that will look to extend his contract straight away. And then Evenvale, again, youngster, but I think we'll be better bringing some people through the club. So we can add him to the transfer list. We've got Murphy on the left. He's on loan from Rangers. And Broadhead and Sakic on the right. Aikens and Bertie. So we definitely need another striker. There's no doubt about that. I mean, let's just get rid of these boys straight away. So early on, I've already announced. So we need a striker. There's no doubt about that. We probably need a small cover on the right. I don't think we've got enough cover there. On the left-hand side, we're looking okay. Centre mids were absolutely fine, and then that right back position. So they're the ones we kind of need to highlight. Obviously, we're working with a very, very limited budget. We can have a look at that now. We've got a transfer budget of 1.46 million, which is very generous, I think. Wage budget is only 16k, so we need to balance what we're going to do. We already do have a scout report that's come through. I'm not sure how many of these are going to be relevant. I don't need a centre back. Centre mid, no. CDM. We can maybe give this lad a scout, maybe. I'm going to scout too many. I'm not sure Ryan Brewster will come to us. But could he be one for the future? Could he be a loan sign? Will we get him in League One? I'm not sure. But maybe we'll add him to the list. I mean, Moiskin's definitely not coming, so I don't know why he's in there. Consum, no. And Tyler Walker will not come to us. Okay, there's another position here. These are all CDMs. I don't think we need any of these. So I think next step, let's go and set up some scouts. I mean, do we already have a scout? Okay, we've got three scouts already. So let's get this lad out. Let's get him maybe doing Spain or something. Get him out there. And let's change some of the instructions. So he's looking at any possession. I don't think we need that. Let's edit this instruction. So we definitely need a right back. We know that much. We need cover at right back. Let's get first team quality in there. Contract's fine. Age, I don't want to sign anybody too old, so I'm going to drop that down to 30. And that should be absolutely fine. And here we've got any position again, playmaker. But again, I think we need to be changing this because again, we know where we need strength. And striker is definitely that role. So let's get looking. Let's get looking for a striker. First in quality, playmaker. Not too worried about the playmaker. First in quality is kind of good enough for this. Pacey would be good though. I like to play at pace when I play on this game, so I'm not too worried about the age there. And then this guy, this is where we want to be looking for. We said right winger, didn't we? Right midfield's fine. And again, we'll just get first in quality and pacey again can be the two to go into that. And that's absolutely fine. Three scouts should be more than enough for what we've got at the minute. I think that's absolutely fine. With Brewster, do I... So loan another... Oh, of course, is it Swansea IRL? We'll leave him in there because he could be... If we go to the Championship, he could be a good loan signing for the next season. So those scouts are out. Okay. Shall we have... Let's have a quick look at our objectives for the season. So Emirates Cup reach round of 32. That'd be tricky. We're within two seasons in the EFL League One, fight for promotion. I'm hoping we'll do that. Playoffs would be nice. Season one, I don't think we'll be good enough to finish in the top two. And then, so they just want us to finish mid-season this year. Youth Academy, sign one Youth Academy, that's absolutely fine. Keep streak of at least 85% attendances and five consecutive matches. Financial, finish the season with 2.7 million unspent. That's going to be tricky. That's going to be very tricky. Considering we want to get some players in, I'm not sure that happened. It's high priority, but maybe we'll get some money for some of our players. That's successful and done, and then continental success, obviously, there is none. Youth staff, obviously, that's always important. Let's just get a scout bought and paid for. Don't want to spend too much money. Charlie Wilson's probably the best at 135k. I'm okay with that. And let's just do England to start. You can often find some good English youngsters out and about, so we'll get him out there and doing his thing. So he's set that. So that's going to be a 3-month scout. The last thing I want to check is... Let's just check the transfer list, just to see if there's anyone as a striker. That's kind of the position that I'm most worried about, really. Let's see if we've got a striker. It's transfer listed. Okay, I mean, Akinfenwa was just not the kind of player that I'll play with. He's 13. Maximin Mbeumo. He could be an option. He's only 28. Value 4. So he's in a wage budget, and if he's transfers, we might be able to get him a lot cheaper than that. So we'll pop a little scout on him. And I'm kind of relying on my scouts for knowledge here. Obviously, as we go on, you know, feel free to get in the comments section, you know, who should we be signing? Who should we be picking in our starting 11? I've got an idea of who I want to pick, but who do you want to see in that starting 11? Are there any good loan signings that you guys have made or any wonder kids at League One level that within my budget I can sign? So you just get down in the comments and let me know. The next one, so yeah, formation. One up top, is that a bit risky? Sarkic on the right's not convincing me at all, I must admit. I kind of like that as a formation though. One up top could serve us well, considering we've only got one out-and-out striker. Bench-wise, I mean, this is okay. We don't need two left-backs. So we'll get the other centre-half in there. It's not looking too bad. We'll see what we can do with it. Let's say this is where we need another striker. But we could go one up top. Aiken's up top by himself. He will be skipper. We'll keep him as skipper. But as a core of a side, it doesn't look too bad. Again, if we can get some cover at right back, get that right winger in and get another striker. If we can get another good striker, it might encourage me to go two up top. But I think to start, I'm okay with that. Tactics, I'm going to leave their roles. Sorry, instructions we will change. Let's have a look here. We want them to get in behind. Defensive, stay forward. Same with him, let's get him in behind. And then defensively again, no, stay forward. Let's get Quinn. That can stay. Attacking, we want you to stay back, Quinny. Stay back while attacking. And then these two, fine. Could we go get in behind? Can we do that with these lads? Okay. Maybe we'll leave that as is, and then the two fullbacks can sort of just naturally do their thing. We'll try and keep it as balanced as much as possible, but we'll save that. I said we'll start with that formation. We'll see where we go from there, lads. Next step, I guess, let's have a look at the calendar. Let's see how the season's going to pan out. So obviously we've got a little pre-season tournament there. If nothing else, it's good for some money into the club. I will be simming that. I never play the pre-season tournament, so don't expect to see that. Now, obviously, I'm going to be planning on doing one video a week. So obviously, if I do one video a week and I play every single game, we are going to take a long time to do a season. So I think the plan is going to be to play one, sim one. And I'll try and play maybe two or three games an episode. But that way, we should be able to do a month. Every episode, we should be able to do a month. Meaning a season will take, I don't know, maybe 9 or 10 episodes. Depending on how long transfer windows take and stuff. So what I'll probably do is I'll probably play that one. Sin Gillingham. I'll play all cup games. Which meaning we'll play two in a row there. And then we'll sim. And we'll just go like that. If, you know, we're looking at a close game or something and we really need to play it, then we'll play it. And the same as if we're in a dead rubber game, we'll just sim it. So hopefully that works for you lads. So let's get on forward. Let's get to this first game. So that our scouts are successful. We've got the training as well. Let's do the training. Let's not forget about that because we know actually on this game that can be quite effective. These are going to be the players just saying, yeah, glad you're selling me. So let's just... just respond to these. You can welcome me to the club. Right, so we'll sim the first game, boys. Go with that as the starting lineup. And then hopefully, you know, a few scout reports will come in. Okay, 2-0 loss to whoever these boys are. It's not the best start as the manager, but again, we should get a little bit of money, if nothing else, even if we lose all of our games. Right, let's get some training done. Let's just quickly rattle off this. I mean, it may be a little bit pointless at this stage because we haven't got the youth players in it, and mainly what I'll use training for is to develop that sort of youth academy that we're going to try and build. Burton as a club have always had quite a good youth academy, so I'm quite keen to keep that going and keep that strong. The side as a whole have got a lot of young players in it as it is, a lot of which, you know, Fox, Vale and Sparrow have all come through the youth academy. So it'd be good to keep that up. Anderson's another one that's come to Youth Academy. This fella is on loan from Leeds, so I don't mind giving him a bit of training to start with. Hutchinson, he's going to be leaving the club, so I don't want to give too much to him. Wallace might be able to progress a little bit. Can't imagine too many of these have got great potential. And then Garrett's the keeper we're going to keep, so he can have a little bit of training. So as we get youth players in, we'll switch this from first team players all to youth players and try and bring through some wonder kids if we can. Right, here we go. Transfer of Hawkins early doors, 85 grand. What's he actually worth? 80k. I'm willing just to accept that. Let's just get that done. Get that penciled in. That reminds me, actually, let's actually go back to our squad and just do a couple of those contracts that we're a little bit worried about. So Daniel, we're going to try and sell anyway, so that's absolutely fine. Wallace is expiring. So let's just get into a couple of these negotiations. We'll do them all. I don't like to delegate too many of them. So let's just do a couple of these very quickly. Here's the gaffer. Here we are, boys. Got the track sheet. Tony Pulis style. Right, accept this. Important. You will be important. He will be staying. He's only 24 years old, so keen to keep hold of him. I have a little 3-year deal, that'll take you to 27. No release clause, that's absolutely fine. At the minute he's on 1.6k, will he say what he wants? Okay, so he wants a little signing on bonus, but he wants his wage to drop, that's fine. I don't mind accepting that. Wallace can stay. Right, next one, O'Toole's fine. Nice, see, on Iro, he's on loan from Chelsea. So I don't know why it says his contract's expiring, but I mean, I'm going to take it because he's a hell of a player. 63 rated at 20 years old. That's absolutely fine. So we'll get him in. He's on 1.5k. Important, yeah. I mean, you'd be probably first name on the team sheet for a lot of it. Actually, you're only 20 years old. I'm going to offer you a 5-year deal. Yeah, he's absolutely loving it. We don't want a release clause. Let's get no release clause. We don't want to get caught out by that. Right, your current wage is 1.5. I'm going to offer you 1.6. Little £100 pay rise. That's fair. He's in the book. That's the second one in. Buxton's expiring in 12 months. I'm not going to worry about Buxton too much at the minute. Brayford I will worry about, though. Let's get Brayford signed up for another couple of seasons. 31, probably just offer him a 2-year deal. You might only want one. Let's get all this little nitty. He's wearing his headband. You respect it. You respect it, John. Let's just get a couple of these players. He's going to be one of our more expensive players, wage budget-wise. That's no surprise there. One of the veterans of the club. 2 years, absolutely fine. No release clause. And I'm going to offer you exactly what you're on now, John. I'm not giving you any more. Let's see if I can just keep you for what you're in. That's absolutely fine. Quinn again, expiring in 12 months. Quite keen to keep him. So let's get him in the book. Oh, his agent looks like his dad. Yeah, crucial. That's absolutely fine. 67 red, 33 years old again. Just a couple of year deal here. Nothing more than that. I just don't want to lose a player of his quality at this level because it's really important. No release clause. You want 2.7. So you actually want to drop. That's absolutely fine. You can take a pay cut if you want. A few of these players, Quinn and Brayford being both of them, actually IRL, have taken pay cuts for the new season. So keen to keep these lads in. All right, Scotty Fraser's another one. Obviously, has left Burton in real life because of because we couldn't get him on a new contract. So let's try and stop that happening. Again, he's a hell of a talent. It's absolutely fine. Get him in. Right, important. He wants a 3-year extension. That's fine. That's taken to 27. That works for us. No release clause required. And I'm going to offer you exactly what you're on now. In fact, no, I'll give you £100 more. Feeling generous. How does that work for you, Scotty? Yeah, he loves it. 2.5k a week. I think for the time being, that's all I'm going to worry about. Yeah, that's what we're going to go with. Right, let's get into the next pre-season friendly. Yeah, it's a little scout report that's coming through. So this is that lad that was from Coventry. 64 rated, 28 years old. Pace-wise, what is this? Acceleration 77, he's a little bit slow. Sprint speed 77. Got a couple of lads that have come through here, though. I'm going to add him to the shortlist. I'm not 100% on him yet. He might be an option just as a backup because we need that backup option. Let's get in and sim the next one. And then maybe we'll have a look at what the scouts are saying and see if we can try and work out what's going on. A little 1-1 draw, it's all on the score sheet. Right, let's get this done again. Same training session as before, lads. It's making literally no difference to those players. Right, transfer-wise. So right back, we've got a couple in. Steven Sessegnon, again, he's going to be out of our bracket. Luther James Wilden from Stevenage. He could be an option. 21 years old. Okay. Kane Wilson, from Tranmere. Again, 19 years old. Lad from Luton. He looks okay. And a couple of these other lads. Again, potential loans. You know, just have a look at all these. Got plenty of time, which is a good thing. Not liking the look of too many of the other ones. Bruce is obviously there. If any other positions come through striker-wise, Torres Campbell from Stoke could be an option for loan. Could be nice and pacey, so that's a positive sign. Vante Cole used to be at Burton. I'm not interested there. And the other ones, his pace might be okay. I'll chuck a little scout there, though. So we're looking at 9 days for scout, so Not too bad a turnaround. And then right wingers. Gavin White. Any really young... Maybe let's chuck a scout on these two lads. Chuck a scout there. See if any of these come back. So we've got a little bit of money to spend at this level. It's not a lot, but we'll give it a go. Say loan options could be the way to go. We've got a little something in our office. Hawkins has been sold, so that's another 50k added to the transfer budget. We'll probably allocate that to wages if required. And last preseason, we actually get a 2-1 win. So that should give us a little bit more money. 360k extra into the transfer budget. That's huge at this level. We'll take that. Daniel suffered an ACL 4 months and he's on the transfer list. That is bad news for us because that means we probably will not be able to sell him yet. Okay. That is a problem. That's a huge problem, in fact. Because not so much for the player, because I wasn't planning on playing him too much anyway, but purely for the fact that we were trying to get rid of him, which may scupper that a little bit. It's a bit of a concern, but we'll see what we can do. We'll see what we can work with. Right. First game of the season is around the corner, lads. We should get some scout reports come through before our first game, which would be quite nice, and maybe we can put a negotiation in place. Stop simulation, let's get training done again. Okay, we've got some scouts in now. Okay, let's have a look. Let's have a look here. So Wilden's a 63 rated. Bond's also 63, and this lad's 66. Wes Harding on loan is kind of the one that's looking at me a little bit. But now with that Daniel injury, not being able to sell him, do we actually need a left-back more as cover? We might need a left-back more than we need a right-back, you know, boys. I think I'm gonna change my opinion straight away. I'm going to leave those boys in there, but before I forget, I am going to change that instruction to be a left-back, which might have been what I said at the start. I might have actually said left-back, not right-back. So that might be completely on me, actually, that I've looked for the wrong position to start with. Okay, let's have a look at these other ones. So this has come through. He's a 67, 1.3. That could be a loan signing. Pace-wise, looks pretty good. Both of these look pretty well. What's his value? 67, 67. Both 67 rated. I might go in for this Tyrese Campbell, you know. I know it's kind of jumping, but although he doesn't look 19, 67 years old, good value. I might go in for him on loan. Again, he's got a little bit of pace that I kind of like. And then the Jordan Green, 63, 65. He's 25, he's 24. Pace-wise, though, these are very exciting. These are both kind of appealing to him. I'm not sure which one. His pace is 9. Okay. I think we're going to go Jordan Green. Yeah, let's go Jordan Green. And I am going to quickly just dive in, see if we can get one of these. Players are not interested in loaning players out. You can try approaching them. Look at loan types. Okay, so he's not that interested. Green. I'm going to try and... It's on loan at another club. Okay, well, that's a really good start for us then, isn't it? Okay, that kind of puts me on the back foot a little bit. Maybe we'll just have to go into the first game and not worry about it too much. Not panic, not rush ourselves into a signing that we don't want to make just because we feel like we need a signing. See if anything else has come through. Transfer for Nati, that's absolutely not happening. Just get rid of these messages, a bit OCD when it comes to stuff like this. Just get rid of them. Right, have the scouts come up with anything else? I think they have. Okay, this lad looks like he might have a bit of potential. Let's get the scout on him. Don't like the look of him. So just chuck out a few scouts, see what happens. I mean, they're only taking 9 days, so it's not too bad. Not worried about... kind of like want to sign some English players and keep that English core of the squad there. Just for like season one, at least. None of these. So they're all got scouts out, so that's absolutely fine. Right, any of these strikers... 27, maybe a little bit old. This like Russian Hemburn Murphy from Derby. Okay, so he's on loan at Derby. That's annoying. Isaac Vassell from Cardiff. Could be an option. They might not want to sell him, but it could be an option. Chuck a scout on this fella as well. He's a little bit older, but we might be able to get him considering Maxwell in the league below. We might be able to prize him away. Alan Zimbana. We'll give you a scout as well. Let's give those three a scout. Maybe one of them will be the one. Bit of a gap here to the first game, which is a little bit annoying. What's this? Another transfer for Quinn again. These are all players that we do not want to get rid of. Just signing new contracts as well, so let's not worry too much about this. Again, go for 9 days. Let's get these scout reports in and see if we can make a signing. Won't get them in time for Ipswich, I don't think. Okay, whatever. Get rid of all the males first. Training injury, who is that? Kieran Wallace-Bruce shoulder, that's absolutely fine. Right, here we go. Let's have a look. So Ben Williams is a 64. Let's get rid of these ones. Jared Bowen. It's an option. He's got a 64 right there. We've got a 66 there. He's got a bit more pace. All right, let's get him in there. We might go for a loan there from the Birmingham lad. Maybe a permanent. Let's have a consider. Right, any of these, 63. His pace is okay. His report's not in. 64. Nice pace. Probably good enough for this level. More so than him. But he's only 22, though. Let's have a look at all of these. Let's just go into the shortlist and... have a little look at what we've got here. This lad's just too slow, isn't he? Yeah, I'm like, let's remove him straight away. Right. Seddon, I'm gonna go in for him. He's on loan at another club, for God's sake. I'm doing very well at looking for those loans at other clubs, am I? Hopefully, who's got the better pace? Sprint speed 83, 82. Is an interesting loaning. Okay. Recently acquired, so I'm looking to negotiate. Is he bloody hell? Okay. Well, this is this is proving somewhat of a nightmare, to be honest, lads. This is proving somewhat of a nightmare. Proving a little bit frustrating. We can have a look on the chat. Let's have a look on the transfer list maybe for a left back. Oh no, not that. Let's have a look on the transfer list. Have we got any good left backs on there? Both a little bit old, but okay. Got scouts of business, that's gonna take like 30 days to do. We're nice to get somebody in, but maybe we're overthinking it just a little bit. But anyway, lads, here we go. We're going to step into game one. At home to Ipswich, tough game. Obviously, Ipswich freshly down from last season from the Championship. That's the starting line that we're going to go with. We're playing world-class five-minute halves, just so you boys know. Let's dive into match one of the season. Here we go then, lads. This is Fortress Pirelli, as it appears on the game. Burton Albion against Ipswich. Can we get off to a good start? Going into this game, I'd probably take a point against a side like Ipswich. Not expecting too much of the game, but just a good performance. If we can keep a clean sheet, happy days, maybe sneak a goal. But I would take a draw in game one. There's no doubt about that. No new signings made by me, as it is anyway. So let's see what we can do here. My lads are ready to go. Jamie Murphy's such a good sign at this level, especially on loan. He's going to be key for us this season. Probably one we'll try and sign at the end of the season when his loan finishes. Here's the start of the lineup, boys. O'Hara in goal. Brafer's going to be playing on the right. O'Toole and Nati in the middle. Wallace on the left. Quinn is the holder man. Edwards and Fraser. And then a front three of Murphy, Sarkic and Lucas Akins. Little 4-3-3 again. That might change over time if we can get a striker in. But time will tell. And we're underway, episode one of our Burton Albion Road to Glory. Here we go, boys. Let's just try and get some confidence and I'll pass it around. There's not too much pace on this side, so my usual way of playing FIFA of exploiting the wings may struggle, season one at least. But we'll try and play some nice patient football, try and knock the ball around. Wear them out early doors, be patient, wait for openings. You know, single man up front, so I've got to be patient and wait for these openings to come about. Fraser nearly loses the ball there, but gets back inside and Akins will hold the ball up and he'll twist it. He'll take an early shot. That's an absolute rocket. We've hit the bar in the first 5 minutes of the game. What a start that would have been. And still we attack and Sarkic is down the right-hand side and he's going to whip in a ball and Lucas Akins isn't there. Brayford sweeps up on the corner though. We lose the ball and Ipswich get their first bit of possession of the game. So we're going to just squeeze with Stephen Quinn. Try and cut off the pass, and he wins it as well. It's really well defended by Quinn. Broadhead in the middle. And switch out wide again to Wallace on the left-hand side. Through ball now from Murphy. See if we can cut this back on the edge. And Fraser's there, and Fraser shoots in. A surely handball. Not given by the referee. Good bit of squeeze. Good start, though, from the Brewers. Good start, 12 minutes in. Promising signs. Edwards now on the edge to Quinn, to Fraser, who's going to take another crap pop, and it's a good effort, but the keeper's up to it. Norris in goal for Ipswich, which is equal to the shot. Got to take these chances, though. We can't let Ipswich settle. We've got to take these chances because they will get a couple. There's no doubt about that. As they take their first attack with Vincent Young, but O'Toole is there. Picks up, and Edwards and the man in the middle to clean up again. Nowhere to go, though, so just going to have to come back to Brayford, who just about keeps it in. Quinn will go for the big switch across the pitch, and Fraser's there. Plays a little lovely through ball to Murphy, who's going to try and get the cross in. Lucas Akins is there, but the keeper's up to it, and Norris comes out and collects that. Again, we're finding some gaps, though. That partnership of Scotty Fraser, Lucas Akins. It's looking nice early doors. Murphy on the left, getting in some gaps, got a little bit of pace behind him. Got to make these chances count. As Ipswich again comes through. Everything's coming through Vincent Young on this left-hand side. But John Brayford stands tall. Nowhere to go. He says, nope, you're not coming through there. Oh, Mance gets passed. Again, Vincent Young seeing a lot of the ball down the left-hand side. And Edwards is there. Big switch across to number seven, Edwards. Not our Edwards, of course, but Edwards of Ipswich is trying to get the ball out. And Nasi should be there to clean up, and he is. Edwards can come away with the ball as he gives it to Quinn. It's a good tackle though. Quinn hasn't got quite the pace. 37-year-old, bit of a veteran. Not quite got the legs in him. Nasi nearly loses the ball. We've got to be careful there. Don't want to fall asleep as Quinn and Fraser link up again. And Fraser's in. He's going to play out wide again to Murphy, who's going to surely try and get the cross in. And Lucas Akins just isn't there. Doesn't quite hold his run. And maybe we should have cut it back to Fraser. already the importance of a player of Murphy's calibre in League One is showing, as Lucas Akins wins a questionable pass but soon loses it again. Lucas Akins is going to try and chase this down though, and puts a bit of pressure and forces the loose ball over the top. So Quinn comes away with it, and it's Fraser again. Plays it out wide into Akins. Akins has got nowhere to go. Quinn will be the man to give him an option, and he's going to be offside if it goes through, but it doesn't. Quinn up again. Nobody's home though, and unfortunately Ipswich come away, and this could be dangerous. This could be very dangerous if we can't stem this. Let's try and put a bit of a squeeze on. Nasty's there, hopefully. Nasty's just going to stand till goes in late. Again, great win by Nasty. Great defender, but he gives the ball away cheaply. Can't afford mistakes like that. First shot by Ipswich, but it's saved, and I think the referee's going to come back for it. No, it's an offside. Ipswich first shot, though. It's taken 38 minutes. We've been pretty resolute as a back four. And it takes a while for their first chance to come. As Wallace plays it in, and Akins makes the through ball. And Akins is running down the wing, and Murphy's going to try and get in the box here. Akins might be able to square this across the box, and does, but there's an Ipswich defender there. Again, another good signs. Another good signs from the Brewers. Good first 41 minutes under the new management. Again, Ipswich doubling up on Murphy. Now they obviously highlight him as the threat. And that's where everything's going through for us. John Joe Tool now just trying to cut it out. That's a great through ball. And Vincent Young seeing plenty of ball down the left-hand side. Again, it's a good cross. And it's just wide. Corner ball. Nasty must have got a little bit on it. O'Hara was scrambling across to the far left-hand side. First corner of the game goes the way of Ipswich. And in it goes. That's a good corner, and Brafer gets it away. And Fraser's going to try and close it down. Lucas Akins back. Quinn's there. Good block by Quinn. Bit of a crossover between the own man. And luckily we get that away. Can we have a break before half-time? No, we can't. And the referee blows his whistle. The end of the first 45 minutes, lads, and it's not a bad half. You know, we've definitely been the better side. We should have been taking our chances, but still in this game, and the second half is anybody's, it really is. So no changes at half-time through either side. We're back underway at the Pirelli Stadium as Lucas Akins tries to hunt down an early interception, and Sarkic again tries to come back, and it's a good tackle. It's a very good tackle to dispossess Vincent Young. And Burton will just spread the play across midfield as Lucas Akins is there. And there is no overlapping run, though. But Edwards can't quite get there. He's a little bit slow, caught on his heels, maybe. Quite seeing the run we want to be seeing there. So it's just passing around here. Just looking to come maybe into the game. Probably had a bit of a stern half-time talking to. They weren't very good in the first half, so they'll be looking to improve, but that's a wayward cross, and that's gone to absolute nobody. And John Brafer just mops up at the back. Tool to Nasty out wide. Fraser goes with a pass to Wallace, and he might look for it back here, and he does. A little 1-2 again. This is lovely football. Surely ref! Oh, I'm not sure about that. How was that not a foul? And Scotty Fraser stayed down, maybe clutching at his shoulder slightly. I'm not sure that's not a foul. It's a great switch there again. Vincent again is the man that they clearly want to get into the game, and Brayford's there. Now, what a save! But they can't get the rebound. And Ipswich, completely against their own of play, take the lead. It was a good initial cross, and I thought we had done enough with the save, but Ipswich unfortunately take the lead. I'm not sure who's got it. Giving them way too much space, and just nobody there. Centre-half's not to be seen, and Nasty can't react quick enough. Bit of afters after the ball goes in as well, but Ipswich 1, Burton Albion 0.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
Not the start we wanted, unfortunately. After rattling the bar and having a few early shots in the first half, we find ourselves trailing in game 1. Fraser has got a knock after that blow that was given, not a foul. Sarkic now, he's got no pace, and that's exactly why we need somebody on the right wing. Quinn now to Fraser. Fraser might have a pop it, and he does. Is there a block on that? No, it's a goal kick. I think it's time for a substitution, boys. I think we need to make something happen here. They bring on Pau. Pau's actually going to come on the right, although he's an out-and-out left winger. Brawler's going to stay on the bench, and Joe Sobrera is going to come on for Quinn, whose legs just look a little bit tired. So make a double substitution. We won't go attacking just yet. I don't think it's quite called for that. We need to keep an eye on this as the substitution is made. Let's just make one as well. Morris on, and Keane is the man to make way. Can we win that though? Lucas Akins can win that. And Murphy's there, and he can't twist and he can't find Akins on the overlap. Again, some good pressure. As Brayford picks the ball up off the throw-in. Sobrera's just come on. Finds Lucas Akins, who twists and turns, but can't find the space to get the shot away. And Ipswich come away again as Sobrera's going to try and cut this out. Ipswich finding a lot of space in the middle, which is slightly concerning. A little bit vacant there, which is not ideal. As Brayford comes forward and gets in the tackle. Oh, that's good football. Ipswich with a 1-2. Shoots and O'Hara's up to it, though. Again, Ipswich really come into the second half, being the better side, I would say. Been caught napping a couple of times, and it's not the ideal start. As the corner comes in, and O'Hara can get there, but it's a scramble. I'm not really sure what's going on. Ipswich get the shot again, but it's wide, and it's a big letter for the Brewers. Goalmouth scramble, and Nolan gets the shot away, but it's always going wide, and Burton look at sixes and sevens here. They really do need to settle down and get back to what we were doing in the first half. Thank you very much, Alan. That's a lovely through ball, and Powers there. Can Akins hold his run? He can't. Oh, and he can't. And through ball goes to Edwards and not to Akins as planned. And maybe we should have had a shot. Desperate times, boys. We need a goal. We need something to happen quick. As we will go attacking. Ipswich come down the line, and again we can't make anything happen, and it's all Ipswich at the minute as they get the lucky break. What a save by O'Hara. He's had a brilliant game for us so far, the man on loan for Manchester United. It's a superb save, but again it's Ipswich that are coming forward, and we could be staring down the barrel of a first defeat of the season. But Fraser does come away with the ball. That's a poor pass, and Murphy's nowhere to be seen. Akins is but back still doing defensive duties off that corner. Akins again tries to cut it off, but it's not going to happen. And Ipswich again just completely dominating the game, and it's one-on-one. And he hits the bar. O'Hara gets up, and it's coming back again. And we'll just about get away with it, but we can't defend the corner. This is tough. We are struggling here. Fraser will come off. Can we try and salvage something here as the corner goes up again, and they have another chance. That's going to go out for a throwing right by the corner flag. Not looking good for us here, lads, I must admit. Okay, we'll try and come away with it. Akins is there, and Akins needs to get forward. Wallace is now the man on the ball, and he will go, and he will stretch his legs, and Edwards is there and tries to find Wallace again, and he does. This could be a good opportunity for us as we try and cut it back on the edge of the box, and Edwards is there, shoots. But Norris is equal to the shot, and we can't quite get him away. Is that curtains? Is that the last chance we're going to get? As the keeper wastes a little bit of time, goes short. Slightly risky. So we'll put on the squeeze. We get away with it. We do get away with it, and Lucas Akins is there. No one to go to. Edwards picks it up on the edge and tries to find Connor, and he does. And Murphy is there. Connor again, and Lucas Akins twists and shoots, and it's going to be wide, and I think that will be it for game one. I think we're staring down the barrel. We've got 2 minutes of added time left, and our career mode is going to get off to a disappointing 1-0 defeat. Very disappointing. We had the chance in the first half. We said we had to take them, and we just haven't. It's a good tackle there by Edwards. This is the last chance, hurrah. And we lose it on the board. Should have just had a pot. Take your chance, Tom. And that is going to be the end of game one. Disappointing defeat. Again, I think a draw would have been a fair result. We were the much better side in the first half, but it's not to be. And our career mode gets off to a disappointing 1-0 defeat at home to Ipswich. But We'll keep our heads up and we'll look to bounce back in our next game. So that doesn't start the way we want to, of course. You know, starting off with a loss is never ideal, but it's a good start. We need to find those layers. We need to get that left back in. We need to get that other striker. And I think two up top is going to have to be the way at the minute. We just can't do it. But it's a good start. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you're liking what you're doing. Like I said, get yourself in the comments. Tell me who you want to see me bring to this club. You know, I want this to be as much as my team as your team and your save as my save. So get yourself in the comments. Let me know who you think I should sign. Are there any wonder kids that I'm missing out on? Is there any hidden gems in League 2 that we should be going after? And of course, if you have liked it, please like and share this video. I will be back hopefully weekly. I'm hoping every Wednesday or Thursday I'll be able to get a video up and be able to go through this whole season. We're going to take this right to the top. It could take us 10 seasons. I know that. But we're going to give it a go. So boys, thank you for watching. And I'll see you on the next video.